Okay, in the next hand zone, we move a little bit further. We know how to use the SPI. Then now we only update our hand zone and we use the interrupt. For me, I start from the scratch. You can use your own hand zone if you want. Then I will here start for sure from beginning. Okay, I have my microcontroller. I will enable the SPI1 in the full duplex mode. Again, the clocks will be not used because I created the loopback between the PA7 and PA6, which is still present on my board from the previous hands-on. I'm still okay with the 16 MHz. But here in the SPI configuration, okay, because I will start and receive the data simultaneously, then I will use the lower Pascal, the lower frequency, to be sure that I avoid the overruns during the sending and the reception. I will check the pins. I have here the maximum speed, the high, no pull-ups, alternate functions, everything is okay here. But here in the NVENC, I need to enable the global interrupt, like in the USART hands-on. I click on the OK. In case that you want, you can here also change the priorities for the interrupts, the preemption priorities. But now I have only this one and the SysTick. Then I'm okay with this approach. I can save now my project as a SPI2. Why not? I here generate this project from Kyle. Okay, and I can generate my project. I can open my project in KL. In case that I installed the KL before, he will search for it, he will find it. Now I can again look on main. It's completely the same like in the previews. I have here the SPI initialization. I need first time compile my code to allow me use the go-to definition. Okay, now I can go to definition. It's completely the same, but as you know, in the interrupt, the change will be in the MSP file, where I here enable the interrupts. Also in the IT.c, here is the interrupt SPI interrupt handler and the HL interrupt handler. Then now in main, I can do the almost the same like before. I define two buffers, one for the transmitting and second one for the receiving. I put here some default values. Okay, and the second variable for the reception for the 10 bits, why not? For the 10 bytes. And then I will call again the same function HL underscore SPI underscore transmit and receive now with the interrupt. Then I will here use the HSPI1 first buffer on the transmit buffer, then the buffer for transmitting, then the buffer for receiving. Then I want to send 10 bytes. Then this is everything from this. But now I also need to search for the callbacks. Then the callbacks, like before, the callbacks will be in drivers. In drivers, I search for the SPI, and I can, like before, search for the underscore underscore week. First, I usually search for the MSP, init and the init, and then I have a transmit complete callback, receive complete callback, and transmit and receive complete callback. Then I will use the this one because I'm using this mode. Then I will put this into my main. I for sure put here my blocking while, famous while one. And I here change the optimization in the project option. Here I will change the optimization to level 0 to allow me see all my buffers. Be sure that the compiler is not so nice that he delete part on reorder my code. Then now I can go into debug. We can see what will happen. Here I will start. Sorry. I will check if I have here my breakpoint. Yes, I'm here. Start again. I have my breakpoint. I can look into my watch. Add buffer to watch. Put it for sure here. If I receive the data which I wanted. And it seems that the data are correct. 38 to the 31. Then it's working. Also be careful on the speed which you are sending and receiving, that the interrupt can be blocking some kind that can also overrun if you have no time to clear all the buffers. Then be careful on this. But this problem can solved on the end the DMA. Then now we look on the example with DMA.